This is the 20-pound aluminum supply tank. It has a dip tube to pull liquid CO2 from the bottom. There is a pressure gauge and an isolation valve. This band heater provides heat to the system. The weigh scale is used to determine how much CO2 is in the supply tank. The supply line delivers the CO2 to the extractor filled with raw material. The CO2 dissolves the extract and delivers it through this line to this valve. The extraction flow rate is determined by this valve. The valve is controlled by this timer and releases pulses of extract saturated CO2 into the collector, where the CO2 converts to gas and the extract falls to the bottom of the collector. The clean CO2 exits out this line into the recapture tank, sitting in the cold antifreeze in a small freezer. The heater is set between 30 and 40 Celsius to generate pressures between 900 and 1400 PSI. The heater is mounted snugly to the tank. The extractor top insert seals with an O-ring. The insert is pushed into the tube and fully seated. The retainer ring is screwed on to hold the insert in place. The retainer ring is only finger tight. At 30 Celsius, the pressure should be greater than 900 PSI. This is the supply tank rotary valve and the isolation valve. The supply tank is positioned on the scale and centered. The weight can be seen. I will zero the scale in advance of the CO2 loading. The supply line valves are open to flow CO2 into the extractor. As the CO2 flows, the weight of the supply tank decreases. The flow will stop once the supply tank and the extractor equalize in pressure. Then the recapture tank valves are opened. Back pressure from the recapture tank pressurizes the recapture line. The cheater valve is open to increase the liquid CO2 level in the extractor. Now close the recapture tank valves and open the relief valve to depressurize the line. Then close the relief valve. The recapture line is disconnected from the extractor and connected to the collector. Open the recapture tank valves to pressurize the recapture line. First, reset the timer. Then push select. Then hold timing recirculate for 3 seconds. This puts it in seconds mode. Then push the minute button until 4 seconds shows and push timing recirculate again. Then push and hold the minute button until 26 is shown and push timing recirculate again. Then push the hour button and then the minute button. Then push confirm. This will start the timer cycle. After the first burst happens, open the collector isolation valve to allow CO2 to flow through to the recapture tank.